Bom, você que você que sabe da Bíblia.
Helson's gonna tell you the story.
Não, você que
that conta we had.
Não, você conta a Bíblia, você conta.
He was like a guard angel taking care of my back. I was trading blows with some guys in a party. The whole party was against us. He's in a horse club in Brazil. And suddenly the guy throws a punch. I ducked it. I duck. When I go back to hit the guy is flat on the floor. I look, Helson's next to me. And he look at me, he goes like this. My little brother, I've been training some boxing, so the punches are sharp. Through that night, he knocked out like 3 or 4 guys after that. And it was an unbelievable night. But there was one motherfucker that hit me from behind. The Helson grabbed him. And the guy was slippery and he was able to get out and jump to the window and took off running. Then I said, Helson, I was angry at him. Helson, you didn't get the guy. You let him get away. Relax, brother. We knock out a lot of people today. Everything is fine. Oh, we cover. We good. We gave more loss to them than we took it. So the game is fair. It's fair game. I said, no, he hit me from behind. We got to get this guy. So me and him, we walk out. As we're walking out, there was a karate guy. Remember he jumped? Yeah, in front of us. I took him down and choke him out like this, and then we took off. We get out of the party, from the Mauro Talma, remember?
Yeah.
We walk out, and me and him are hiding under a tree, waiting for the guys to come out.
You give me ideas, I fall. Let's wait for the guys. Okay, yeah. Let's wait for the guys.
Let's hide under the tree and wait for the guys. They're gonna come out this way. They have to come out this way. I was, okay, if they came out, we get them. Then suddenly the guys came out, but it was like 5 or 6 guys walking out, you know. I said, look, Helson, the guy's there. The guy had a jacket, a brown jacket with like a few stripes on the back. So like he couldn't pass unnoticed. So I said, that's him. Let's go, Helson. Helson, oh man, we gotta wait. We gotta wait because the cavalry is coming. We are the good guys, and the good guys always wait for the cavalry. You have just to wait when the cavalry arrives. The cavalry that he was talking about is our friends because we are outnumbered by them. And I said, but Helson, I can't wait. I gotta get that guy. He hit me from behind. I wasn't looking. And he goes, no, little brother, let's wait. Brodinho, let's wait. Brodinho, let's wait. I said, Helson, if they hit the other side of the curb, I'm going. You don't need to come. I go by myself. No, Brodinho, my little brother. If you go, I'm gonna come with you. But we are the good guys. Just wait a little, the cavalry is coming. Look, I told you. When I looked, my cousins were walking out of the party too. So we became an even number, you know? And he goes, I told you, the good guys always win in the end. The cavalry arrived. So then we went. And we did a good job. But Helson never fought in the street or nothing like that. Helson.
That's one thing in Brazil you need to be done, and sometimes, you know, it's hard to get away these fights because the thing starts so fast, and then people don't care. People don't have consequence about these fights in Brazil. Nobody got arrested for these things. One day I'm talking to people in the internet, and then people come to, oh, Mr. Grace, I hear you have like a bunch of the street fights in the street. I say, yes. And the guy like it, he wanna play with me. Well, how many fights? I say, maybe 50, 60 street fights, different situations, different reasons for them, or always 100% of the reason. You know, Mr. Grace, in America, you are a criminal. You are trying to make me guilty. Say, yes, maybe us, for the number of the fights, but never because I fight all the reason. Então, this is one thing I keep you today in my life, God bless us, as I have this record in street fights, and then 50 street fights, I never got a punch really in the face.
What did you answer to him when he said that you were a criminal?
Then I'd say, I think you, in America, you're a criminal. I'd say, well, see, I'm a criminal for defense of myself and the rights. I'm going to be a criminal here. I'm going to be a criminal in Brazil. But I tell you something, doesn't matter what I am. See, you guys give me a right to fight. If you come to school, you throw something in my school, if you grab my daughter, if you push me in the middle of the night, I'm going to defend myself. You're going to be another case.
But you know what you should have said to him?
No, and then I
you
told him.
You know what I should have said to him?
No, and then
in Brazil, I'm a criminal. Now in America, I'm a criminal, but in Brazil, you would carry my lunch bag.
Exactly. And then that's what I told him. That's exactly what I told him. In Brazil, I need to take care of my business. I need to take care of my survival. Yeah. So you guys, please don't compare this here. And then he keeps saying, Mom, it's very bad. This is your record. I say, sir, I like it. And then I explain. For the right reasons, I can still fight today. In America, I never got arrested. I have a couple fights here in Hawaii.
Did you?
Yeah, one in the soccer field. One in the soccer field, my daddy watched. Ele Gracie,
why?
Here
why
watched.
You fought in the soccer field?
Because
you play
soccer
very well.
Yeah, and then I have a little disagreement.
Have you seen him play soccer?
Have a little.
Jesus Christ, whatever he is, I'm on the other side.
I'm the best player in the family, too. These guys don't know play soccer, man. These guys don't know.
I'm surrounded by lunatics. This one is the best soccer player.
Hickson
is the best surfer. Look at this.
No. Hickson, I need to see who stay longer in the beach, who stay longer in the field. I stay longer in the soccer field with Hickson. I'm staying longer in the beach with the Hickson. That's true. I got more practice. I got more work in that. That's true. Hickson is still my young brother. Anyway, this day I have the field, and then I have like 11 play, but the guys have 8 supplies. And for some reason, the guys start change, 40 in, 40 out. The guys never tire, always fresh. And then I start play hard, and then every time I play hard, they have a little disagreement in the field. The guys split the ball. The Brazilian came with carrinho. When the guy kicked the ball with carrinho, the guy fall in the ground. And then he stand up with attitude when he run, not supposed to kick the ball. When he kick, when they press the ball.
By the way, let me just translate you. When he say that he was playing a little harder, he means that he wasn't looking at the ball anymore. Just the guy's legs.
No, I'm a fair player. Anyway, the thing's going like this. Then in the end, the guy disagreed, and then start push here, push there, and then start a big fight. And then eventually, that's like I say, when this start, having two guys face each other, then the Hawaiian push him, and then he push another guy. And then come one from behind. The guy run, he jump, whole players in the field. Everybody have clicks. And then the guy run, fast run, and then he jump with the knee in the back. When the guy, my friend back me, and then this guy run, hit to his knee, right in the spine. He run, he put the knee up. He's gonna broke his spine. When the guy run, I only push the guy. This guy pass, some hands miss a punch behind me. Se eu não empurrasse o cara, eu ia tomar uma porrada. Mas porque eu empurrei o cara, a mão passou. The hands passed.
My lucky hit.
When he
passed, the guy, someone was throwing a punch.
That's funny, because when he passed, and I see his hand, I push the guy. So when I see the guy's pass, I spill like this. I hit the cara desse lado, tá entendendo? Foi uma parada louca pra... He said, stand up a sec. Let me show you this fast. Let me show you this. Like this. Like, he's gonna punch me here. I do like this, I push the guy. I spill like this. I get him from another side. Yeah, when the guy passed a mão, I like this, I spill around. I got him from behind. You know, and then he fall, and then I kick it there, and then he start really high. And then
this is a friendly soccer game.
Yes, and they 8-5, 4-1. For my team
you're
run.
You're in a civilized world now, Papa.
Only 7-8. But I fight 18. 18 players come, start mobbers. And then 7 fight 18 people. When the end started, when the cops come. No kidding. Yeah, because the fight kept
going. Another story when the cops
my
come.
My dad is the referee. My dad
was the referee.
Elio Gracie, come. Just Kimo's fight. No, just Dan Seven's fight. No, Kimo's fight. I'm sorry. Just Kimo's fight. And then Kimo fight Friday. Next Saturday they have this game. My daddy come with me. And then when this happened, this fight done, my daddy come again. You see the big local boy. Hey, you again. Come over here. He's dead. Enough. Already fight. No, hey. And the guy come and then start again. The guy, take this one. And then start again.
So
big battle.
He started the fight again.
No, my daddy pushed the fight to go. Hey, look, I don't help you. Get the good one. The big one there. Talk shit. Come. And then he come the big one, man. The guy like 6'2". 220 pounds.
Leave this shit alone.
And then I start clinching the guy again. And then anyway, the cops come. I know got one punch again. Everybody got beat. The guys, real broke ribs, face, bunch. And when the cops come, have like 7 guys. Over there, 18 guys. Over there, 8 people bleed. Eyes like this, ribs broke, you know? Because one fall, I click right in his ribs.
No,
and then hold this thing happen. And then eventually I got saved again. God bless me again. The cops come, ask the guys, the local guys want to arrest us because all these guys bleed. And they say, no. Then the one police officer watch, you know, and say, let's change the rights. Supposed to know, you guys want to sue the local guys because the police officer saw up there you see us right 100%. And then, like I say, that's a fight to happen in Hawaii, in USA. In the end, the cops come and I don't got arrested again. Because I'm 100% right. Okay, that's the point. So I think it's very important.
That's the point.
That's the important. Doesn't the matter point, where
I'm gonna,
you fight.
I'm going to tell you what the point is.
Be the right.
If you are in a street fight, better have health on your side. That's the
only
point.
Only you're right. Only you're right. Only you're right. You know, I disagreed with members of the family when they abuse, they take advantage. No, you cannot. Yes, I need to be keep the jiu-jitsu as self-defense and make saviors, use this in the streets with the rights to doing. And that's the idea. So I'm not a bad man. I'm never going to be arrested in Hawaii. I have like 3 or 4 fights in Hawaii. I never get arrested. And then cops come sometimes, pull over, you ask me. And then
what about me growing up? You hear stories about it?
Yes. How Hanzo, it's the one, is the most, he's the one before, is the most hot blood. Because he lives in Quebramar. And then he have a lot of fights over there. I know Hanzo. Some of my friends don't go surf in Quebramar because of Hanzo, Ryan, and Ralph. Yeah. Okay. And then Hanzo, for like, when you grow like 19, 20, he's still doing these fights a lot. Like I said, I have a couple ones together with him. I see a lot of his fights there. He always fight with the rights.
I'm always right.
Always right. Always fight with the rights. With the rights. And then, yeah, with the real 100% right. And then one of these days, Hanzo got involved in the fight too. I'm not there. And the guy shooting him. He fight a guy, he beat up another one, he come another one, hey, everything threat. Then one, the third guy pull his gun. You want the hands still run over the revolver. And the guy shooting him like 2-3 times. One got up here, one broke his femur, one burned his ribs, one got in the arm, right? And then that's the last time I see Hanzo in Brazil, in the time I leave Brazil. I visited him in hospital. He had 3 shots in his body. And then not because he fight the wrong, that because some people, in his, when you start getting 19, 20, start going clubs, or ages more, you can, you know, get involved
older
with
people.
Old people. In Brazil, a lot of guys get gun. And when these guys pull the gun, from hands was nothing. He run over the gun, and then he tried to get the gun with the gun. And then the guy shooting him, eventually catching him in 3 times. And then that's one of the last times I saw hands in Brazil. I go in the hospital, I visit him.
Yeah, he moved his leg to America, around. Became
yeah, he had a broke femur, a dislocation, his hips bone. And then that's a terrible situation for him. I think after that, he start going more. Yeah, this start going a little bit more. Think about these things, and I don't think his fight is good for nobody. I'm never gonna be proud to talk about beat up people, this or that. But some ones deserve, you know. More, I think the Grace family keep this record in the streets a lot. You know, never get beat in the streets.
Deserve. Only people who deserve.
Exactly. But some
deserve.
People, yeah.
We are punishers. We are educators.
You call
we
like
educate
that.
Them. We educate people.
Educate people. Yeah. Some ones, I need to be real mean. I be some real mean ones. If some ones, you let it go.
Tell that one that the guy told
he passed him out and then scratch his face.
No, he was going to take his shoes off.
Jefferson. No, Anderson from Urca. No, this is a big guy. They're like 230 pounds. He's 2 times champion in the beach, soft sand in the beach. It's hard to be 2 times champion in the beach, soccer beach, because tough players, you know, tough teams. This guy's from Guaíba, from Urca. Every time he fight in Figueiredo Magalhães with Juventus, there's a battle. Pinduca fight him every day. The field got fight, weapons, shoots, run. That's terrible, these games, man, Guaíba. And this guy is the number one there. This guy come to my table one day. I have the table. I go to get something to drink. When I come back, he sit with my girlfriend.
And your girlfriend?
Yeah, Gisele. And then she's beautiful, gorgeous girl. And then I'm with her. I like beautiful women. I love beautiful. And then I have, anyway. And then I have one kind like that. And then she's very beautiful, very nice. And the lady for a minute, when I see this monster sent to my table, and then I come to him, Gisele, you're gonna introduce your friend? She turned her back. She said, no, she's not my friend. She said, no, he looks like, it's happy, man, nice to meet you. He don't talk to me. He looked me, ignored. He didn't keep talking to Gisele. Say, Gisele, you want to, no, this guy bugging me here. And then I say, excuse me, my friend, what's your name? I don't here to talk. I want to talk to her 1 second, I leave. Wait 2 minutes, I leave. Say, no, you don't understand, she's my girlfriend. Oh, I don't see her for a while in the beach. Well, he gave his reasons. And then I explained to him, she's not around because she with me. More, you don't want to hear, he's a big guy, he think he can take result in other ways. And then I told him, hey, man, listen, I think you start getting inconvenient for us, this talk to talk, this is my girlfriend. What another, you know the result, you have plenty of beautiful women here. It's like 3-1 in Brazil, 4-1. Have 200 girls, 80 people in the party. Can you find another one so beautiful? I say, okay, now wait a minute. Wait, I'm gonna talk to her, then I leave. She says, you don't understand the point. I say, wait, what do you want? You wanna result the another way? I say, any way you wanna result. This is my girlfriend. You wanna fight for her, fight for it. Then she say, okay, let's go. I say, okay, I don't wanna fight because I know whole club, I know the bosses, I know everybody. I'm never gonna fight inside the clubs. I try to get away. And then I told him, let's go downstairs. And then he'd say, look at me, oh yeah, let's do it downstairs. Okay, I'm going downstairs. Okay, go ahead, I don't miss you. Go and meet you down there. When you walk, he stopped, he back to my girlfriend, say, honey, I'll be back.
I'll be right back.
Yes, I'm gonna take care of this business, I'll be back. This for me, that's the end, you know? Because it's not this, it's not only I lost the fight. See, I lost my girlfriend too, I don't know what's gonna be. Lost the fight to a team, you lost your girlfriend.
Look good? Did she look good?
She's the best. The guy's a giant, then I don't have a choice. I'm gonna put in my, anyway, you're going downstairs, I'm going downstairs, I follow him. Went downstairs, you're going one side, I'm going another one. I bring Marcelo Berry with me, Marcelo Berry in Malibu.
The guy said that he was gonna beat the crap out of Malibu too, right?
Yeah, and then he walked to the lights. I walked on the dark side. And then when they go into the lights, they see me come back. Malibu come down, don't see nobody. Hey, where do you guys go? The guy behind him, I say, Malibu, shut up, faggy. And then the guy come, oh, you Malibu. You wait here, you the next.
I'm gonna beat him up, I come back.
They'll come back and beat you too. And then I walk outside, then I take my shirt, take your shirt, say, man, before they start the fight, I propose something. Sir, listen, me and you fight here, 200 girls over there, no real, no. And then he say, okay. Então, let's do something. When I go up there, you shut up, I talk to Gisele. Say, what? Well, when I get up there, I'm gonna sit in the table, I'm gonna talk to your girlfriend. When I say the third time, he start repeat, I slap his face. I take him down right away, mounting. The time I'm talking, the fight run. I take him down, 2-3 points in the face, he turn his back, I squeeze, he pass out. Fast like the guy's
a arm lock after.
No, no, I pass out, he pass out. Most too fast, I still upset for the fact. He tried to steal my girlfriend. When he passed out too fast. I lay down over him, scratch his face on the floor like this.
And by the way, the floor is
shaved. Make his nice look shaved. He deserves.
Did she look good?
It's rocks, stones.
Did she look good? The girl look good?
The girl looked good, but the girl looks ugly because I shaved him for her. Everything come blood. And then when he sleep, the kids around, the poor kids ask for his shoes, his clock, his watch, his change, his wallet. His bell, the kids clean him up.
The kids clean
him up. Take his shoes, wallet, his pass out. I wait till my dad would say, wild horse, you don't get out the horse. Wait till him wake up in the mounting position, because he's gonna come wild again. And then I'll sit in him, a comfortable seat. I let his turn to me again. He wake up, turn to me. When you see, he wanna continue the fight. He stretched his arm, I broke his arm. It's a nice arm lock. And then when he realizes I'm broke, oh, you broke my arm. I say, well, sir, you know, thanks for the arm. I'm sorry, the inconvenience, I'm be here. I told you, let's back to the girls, you know. And he broke his arm, and then he start looking for his shoes, his wallet, what's his shoes? So the kids take, run after the kids. He don't want to run after the kids. And then I ask him, oh, my girlfriend wait for you. You want to come back over there? He look at me and say, motherfucker. But listen, you don't respect this happy, you know what I mean? God bless, I have my jiu-jitsu with me. Yeah, I use it the right way. He never gonna forget that. He going back to worker.
Because it could be you.
It can be you, anyone.
Thank God was him. Boy, he fixed the guy up, he's an educator, boy.
After the fight, the guy, like, hold his face, it's black, his skin. And then people, the kids, the worker ask, what happened to your face? What happened to your arm? He start lying. He'd say, a bus hit him. He threw him in the face on the ground. Your bus hitting him. The kids go in my school, my tie, he ask Hickson. Hickson, you big, you know, Anderson? Me, Hickson, right side to side. You know Anderson? The guy say, no, I don't know Anderson. Hickson don't know Anderson. And then I know Anderson. The kids say, oh, you know Anderson, yeah. You don't want to fight him? I say, why? No, because in the worker, he just say he got hit for a bus. And then Hickson slapped my shoulder and say, this is the bus. The kids kiss my shoulder, kiss my hands, kiss my arm.
Because the guy was a thug.
Because this guy taking the balls from the kids in the beach, you know? He kicked the kids' ass. And so I think he got this beat because God deserved. God sent him, like Hans would say, God sent to him for the right guy to fix, shave him in the right time.
He became a much better man after that.
Yeah, he never fight again.
He's not a family man.
God bless. You see?
Married, decide to take the right path. After the house was...